Hello, my name is Pooja Kadam and I'm working as Assistant Professor in Vidyavardhini College of Engineering, Vasai. Now, as a part of Open Educational Resource, today I will be explaining you a presentation on water treatment plant topic. I have divided this topic into two parts. In this PPT, I will be explaining you the first part. Water treatment plant is a topic inside environmental engineering subject of third year civil in semester 5th of Mumbai University. So that is the reason I have taken this topic. Now, starting with, where does pure water come from? How does it reaches your homes? So the answer to this is the water treatment plant. Being a civil engineer, it is not just our responsibility to construct a building. It is our responsibility even that the residents living in that building should get adequate quantity and quality of water. So it is mandatory to have the knowledge of water treatment plant. Now, water treatment plant purifies the raw water of natural water sources and makes it pure for drinking. There are several unit processes in a water treatment plant. So we'll go through it one by one. First is collection by intake structures. Second is screening. Third is aeration. Fourth, sedimentation. Fifth, sedimentation with coagulation. Sixth, filtration. Seventh is disinfection. Eighth is storage. And finally, distribution. Now, this is a simple layout showing you the water treatment plant and its distribution. First, the water is collected from the natural water sources, then it goes to the different treatment units in a water treatment plant. Then it is stored in an elevated service reservoir from where it is then distributed to your homes and industries. Now, what are intake structures? Now, we all know that water is originally collected from natural water sources, be it river or lake or a reservoir. But how does that raw water reaches to your water treatment plant? So mediator between them is nothing but the intake structures. In simple language, intake structures are nothing but those are concrete structures which are going to store the water from the river or the lake and make it available to water treatment plant even in the dry seasons. So, intake structures are used for bringing together water from surface sources such as river, lake and reservoir and passing it further to the water treatment plant. These structures are masonry or concrete structures and provides comparatively clean water free from pollution, sand and obnoxious or say objectionable floating matter. Now, depending upon where this intake structure is situated, it is divided into river intake, lake intake. So, one of it is river intake. This is a type of intake structure which may either be located suitably inside the river so that demands of water are met with in all the seasons of the year, or they may be situated near the river bank where an adequate depth of water is available. Sometimes an approach channel is constructed and water is led to the intake tower. Now basically your intake structure looks like this. So this is a kind of river intake structure. Depending upon the level of the water, that is HFL and LWL, you have different penstocks for collection of water. This whole thing is a concrete intake structure where water is being stored. After that water is being stored in this, you have a strainer which strains out the objectionable floating matter, and through the pumps, the water is pumped through the suction pipe and then it is transported to the treatment plant. So basically, the pre-treatment, say removal of the floating matter, is also removed in this intake structure as well. These penstocks are also provided with the screens. And this strainer also helps in removing those impurities. Now, next is screening. When your water reaches the water treatment plant, the first unit which it undergoes, the first unit process is nothing but screening. Screening is the first unit operation used at water treatment plant. Screening removes objects such as racks, paper, plastics, metals to prevent impairment and blockage of downstream equipment, piping and appurtenances. So water treatment plants use both coarse screens and fine screens. Now water treatment plant has two types of screens, that is coarse screen to remove large size particles and fine screens to remove comparatively smaller size particles. Now, coarse screens remove large size solid rags and remains from the water, wastewater, and typically have openings of 6 mm or larger. Now, types of coarse screen include mechanically and manually cleaned barred screens, including trash racks. Barred screens have another name which is called as the trash racks. Then you have fine screening, which is used to remove material that may create operation and maintenance problems in downstream processes, that is, in other unit processes, particularly in systems that lack primary treatment. Typical opening size of fine screens are smaller, very small compared to coarse screening, that is 1.5 to 6 mm. Now, these are nothing but the coarse screening in the form of bars. And this is nothing but the fine screening. Then, after screening, that is after the floating matter is removed, your water then goes to the aeration process. Now, what is basically aeration? Aeration means bringing water and air together so that more of the dissolved oxygen, more of the oxygen is from the atmosphere is dissolved inside the water and the harmful gases from the water are released into the atmosphere. Now, aeration brings water and air in close contact in order to remove dissolved gases such as CO2 and oxidizes dissolved metals such as iron, hydrogen, sulfide and volatile organic chemicals. Aeration is often a major process at the water treatment plant. During aeration, constituents are removed or modified before they can interfere with the treatment processes. Now, aeration brings water and air in close contact by exposing the drops or thin sheets of water to the air or by introducing small bubbles of air and letting them rise through the water. The scrubbing action process caused by turbulence of aeration physically removes dissolved gases from solution and allows them to escape into the surrounding air. One simple example of aeration which I can give you is the waterfall. Everyone knows you feel so fresh near a waterfall. You see the waterfall, the water in the waterfall is so fresh. Why is such? Because there is turbulence inside the water which is falling. More of the water is exposed to atmosphere. So, more of the oxygen is dissolved into the water and the harmful foul gases are released into the atmosphere. So, that water seems to be very pure. So, that is the simple example which I can give you for aeration and same thing is applied in these processes also. Now, there are different types of aerators to carry out this aeration processes. The most common aerators that are used in the water treatment plant are, first is the gravity aerators. In gravity aerators, water is allowed to fall by gravity such that a large area of water is exposed to atmosphere, sometimes aided by turbulence. Now, in gravity aerators, there are two types, that is, cascade aerators and multi-tray aerators. See, this is the cascade aerator, where steps are provided and water is made to fall through the steps by gravity. So, more of the water is exposed to the atmosphere and that is why it seems to be pure water. It is a pure water because more of the oxygen from the atmosphere gets dissolved into the water. This is a type of multi-tray aerators where the water is made to fall through these trays. Then, next is the fountain aerator. These are also known as the spray aerator with special nozzles to produce a fine spray. Like you see a fountain, this fountain aerator is same like that. Someone may feel it like a fountain for aesthetic view, but this fountain which is used in the water treatment plant is for exposing the water to atmosphere and making the oxygen to get dissolved into it and making the gases inside the water to get oxidized and removed from the water. Or next is the injection or diffuse aerator. It consists of a tank with perforated pipes, tubes or diffuser plates fixed at the bottom to release fine air bubbles from the compressor unit. So this is what is air diffusion aerator. It looks same like your fish pond. In fish pond also you provide compressed air so that dissolved oxygen is made available to fishes. In the same way, air diffusion aerator works where compressed air is passed through these diffusers inside the tank which has the water to be treated so that the oxygen gets dissolved into the water. Next is the mechanical aerators, that is mixing paddles as in flocculation are used. Paddles may be either submerged or at the surface. See, this is one of the kind of the mechanical aerator that is being used for treatment of the water. Where you can see the motor is being situated at the surface or it might be situated inside the water so that turbulence is provided inside the water and it is exposed to atmosphere. Now, after aeration, where your water goes to is the sedimentation tank. Now, sedimentation tank has different names. It is also called as a settling tank. It is also called as a clarifier. Clarification is nothing but sedimentation only. Now, sedimentation tanks allows the suspended particles to settle out of water or the wastewater as it flows through the tank, thereby providing some degree of purification. A layer of accumulated solids called as the sludge forms at the bottom of the tank and is periodically removed. Now, there are different types of sedimentation tanks. Now, sedimentation tank is nothing but making your water stagnant or say still so that more of the impurities get settled down at the bottom. Now, sedimentation tanks are of different types. Based on the method of operation, there is fill and draw type of tank and second is the continuous flow type of tank. And based on the shape, you have circular tank and rectangular tanks. Now, fill and draw type of the sedimentation tank. The name has the meaning of it. That is, water is being stored in the tank for some time and after that specific time, it is being removed from it. And that time is nothing but it is called as a detention period. In case of fill and draw type sedimentation tank, water from the inlet is stored for some time. The time may be 24 hours. In that time, the suspended particles are settled at the bottom of the tank. After 24 hours, the water is discharged through the outlet. Now, since this requires a lot of time, which is not feasible in a water treatment plant, so this is not being used. And that is why you have a continuous flow type of tank. Now, this one is the diagram for a fill and draw type of sedimentation tank, which is not being used nowadays because it requires a lot of time, which is not possible for a water treatment plant of a city. So then you have a continuous flow type of sedimentation tank. Now in this type of tank, water is not allowed to keep at rest, but water is made to flow through the tank through a very small or very less velocity. And during this flow, maximum suspended impurities which have a high specific gravity then settles down at the bottom. So this is a type of a continuous flow sedimentation tank. You can see there are baffles which are also called as the baffle walls which are provided inside the tanks. These baffles are nothing but they are used for reducing the velocity of the water which then thus reduces the detention period of the which thus increases the detention period of the tank which helps in increasing the efficiency of the sedimentation tank. Now, there are two types, that is horizontal flow sedimentation tank and vertical flow sedimentation tank. In horizontal flow sedimentation tank, it is mostly the rectangular shape sedimentation tank where the water is made to flow from one inlet to an outlet, providing the length twice its width so that maximum amount of suspended impurities settles down if the velocity is increased, if we increase the length of the tank. The maximum permissible velocity in this case is 0.3 meters per second. Vertical flow is mostly the circular shaped tanks where the water flows in the vertical direction from a central pipe. Then you, depending upon the shape, you have two types of tanks, that is circular tank and the rectangular tank. This one is a circular tank where you provide mechanical scrapers at the bottom to remove the settled sludge and water is passed through, water is made to flow from central pipe. And this then next you have this rectangular tank where I showed you that you provide baffle walls to make the detention period increase the detention period and increase the efficiency of the sedimentation tank. Thank you.